from WeBeatFat.com, and I'm here with another video for you. I'm very, very excited, and because I think I've finally like found my direction and where I want to take my vlogs and my blog and all that stuff. It's just something that I've really, really been searching for, because my main goal with all of this is to help people, and so that is the one thing that I really, really want to do. So I'm going to like give you a little more backstory on me and everything, but it's October and it's Breast Cancer Awareness Month, and I have to tell you a little story that I've never ever really shared with people. It's kind of, I don't know, I've never felt like that it was my story to share, but it's something that greatly affected me during my weight loss journey. The year that I reached my goal weight was 2012, and I reached my goal weight February 2012, and June 2012 my mom was diagnosed with breast cancer, and it was literally a day that changed my life, because like she had called me a couple of days before and she told me that she had found a lump, but like I didn't want to take it seriously. I didn't want to think about it, because like nobody wants to think about that. But she went and got it tested, and it came back that it was cancer. And from that moment on, I knew that things would never ever be the same. And it was really, really hard for me to deal with, because that was my mom, my very, very best ultimate friend in life. And it was just a very, very scary moment for me. So I kind of took it upon myself to like really see after my mom, because it's always kind of just been me and her. And it was just very scary, because I did not want to lose my mom. Cancer is a very scary thing, and I just wanted her to be okay, and that was the only thing that I could keep thinking, was that she needed to be okay. So my mom started off with her first week of radiation, actually the week of my birthday, I do believe. And radiation was, it went by very quickly, and you know, like I was there for her. Thankfully I had a lot of support, and it was pretty, that was the biggest thing. And I was trying to get all the information that I needed to help my mom better understand what was going on, because you know, hearing that is a very, very scary thing. But I just wanted to be there for her, and I've watched this process, the radiation, and then after that she went on chemo, and it was just a very, watching my mom have to go through all of that was very, very hard. There was, my natural reaction is to always want to fix things, and I couldn't fix this for her. The only thing I could do was be there for her and try to be that positive spirit in her life, because the one thing that I knew needed to happen was she needed to come out of that okay. And that was the only thing that I focused on. I was trying to be strong for her when I knew that she couldn't be strong. So in those moments, a lot of things changed for me, because I watched the struggle that she went through, and it was scary. And you know, I was there at every appointment, every chemo. My mom stayed at my house, you know, and I just, you know, there were lots of complications along the way. She ended up having to get blood transfusions because the chemo was really getting to her. So I basically like stopped doing everything so that I could help her. You know, I still wanted to, you know, keep a normal life, staying on my healthy lifestyle kick was, you know, something that was very important to me, and it also helped me deal with the stress of it all. So I'm glad that I was still able to stay on track. Like, even during that time, I didn't gain any weight. Nothing happened because, like, I had learned to deal with my stress and my emotions so much better than I had before. But those were the moments that changed me. And that is really, really the reasons why I have this take life by the horns attitude and just do everything. Because I've watched my mom struggle with that, and she gave up so much of her life for those moments. And, you know, I was just an innocent bystander, but I learned so much that we have to live life while we have it. We are not promised a tomorrow, and we don't even know what's going to happen. So live your moments to the fullest. And that is why, you know, people often ask me why I started running so much or why I travel so much. It's because that is the one thing that makes me happy. And as long as it makes me happy, I'm going to do it, because I don't want to waste any more time in life at all. I've wasted so much more time before. Watching my mom struggle and fight for her life was the biggest eye-opener that I should be living my life right now. And so, like, that is the reason why I travel so much, why I run, why I want to see so much, why I want to do so much, why why I do what I do. Like, that's why I want to help people. I want to share. I just want my life to mean something. And, you know, like, I don't want to look back and be like, oh, well, I should have done this or I should have done that, because I already have those moments. But right now, I'm living the life that I want to live because I'm making it happen for myself. And so it's just a moment. Moments can change you, can change your focus, can change your direction, and it can be a very powerful and wonderful thing. So this weekend is, I'm telling you all this because this weekend is a celebration for my mom because she is cancer-free. She has been cancer-free for 2.5 years now, I do believe. And I'm telling you this because tomorrow is the Gift of Life Color Rush, and I'm going to be out there doing that with my mom. And I just never really told anyone the backstory about all this. I've watched cancer has affected my family, the closest person to me, and I just want you to know why it's important to me. And so I guess that is where I will end this part of the video, and you'll get to see more of the Color Rush. It should be a really good time and a great celebration, and I can't wait to share it with everyone. So I'll see you then.
Like a small boat on the ocean, sending big waves into motion. Like how a single word can make a heart open. I might only have one match, but I can make an explosion. And all those things I didn't say were wrecking balls inside my brain. I will scream them loud tonight. Can you hear my voice this time? This is my fight song. Take back my life.
My fight song.
into motion, like how a single word can make a heart open. I might only have one match, but I can make an explosion. This is my fight song. Take back my life.
Congratulations, cancer survivors. You give us courage, hope, and love. And now, if our survivors will please take your balloons and prepare for a very, very poignant release honoring survivors.
Are we ready?
Yeah. This is my fight song. Take back my life. Still got a lot of fire left in me.